يا من عصيت الله يوما غافلا أنسيت أن الله قد أعطاك نعما.
واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أيها المسلمون قال الله جل وعلا محمد رسول الله والذين معه أشداء على الكفار رحماء بينهم تراهم ركعا سجدا يبتغون فضلا من الله ورضوانا سيماهم في وجوههم من أثر السجود ذلك مثلهم في التوراة ومثلهم في الإنجيل. الله جل وعلا في سن سباس Muhammad is the messenger of Allah, and those with him are severe upon those who don't believe and are merciful towards each other. You see the bowing and prostrating, seeking the pleasure of Allah. This is how Allah Jalla wa Ala, He described the Sahaba of the Messenger radiallahu ta'ala anhum wa ardahum. These were the people who supported the Messenger alayhi salatu wasalam when he was exiled from his land, his city, the city he was born in. He was exiled, driven out, and he looked at it alayhi salatu wasalam and he said, إِنَّكِ لَأَحَبِّ الْبِلَادِ إِلَيْهِ. He said, "Verily, you are the most beloved land to me, Mecca. وَلَوْلَا أَنَّ قَوْمِي أَخْرَجُونِي لَمَا خَرَجْتُ. And if my people didn't drive me out, I would have never left." That's how much the Messenger عليه الصلاة والسلام loved Mecca. But despite all that, he was driven out, forced out, and he left. And he was, before he migrated, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to Al-Madinah, he sent an ambassador, Mus'ab ibn Umayr, a young man, who embraced Islam at a young age, sacrificed so much for this faith. This young man, Mus'ab radiallahu ta'ala anhu, his mother was wealthy. He was known to, if he walked past a certain street in Mecca, the people would know because of the fragrance. He was known by his beautiful fragrance. Radiallahu ta'ala anhu wa ardah. After he embraced Islam, his mother, she refused to give him any more money. She cut him off. He starved. He lost all the privileges he had. But he did this for his religion and Islam. And like him is another Sahabi, Sa'ad ibn Abi Waqas, radiallahu ta'ala anhu wa ardah. He was very dutiful to his mother. He loved her, he adored her. After he embraced Islam, رفضت والدته أن تأكل وأن تشرب وأن تستظل. His mother, she refused to eat and drink and to seek shade. She refused all of that. She refused to do those things. Why? Because she wanted to convince him to leave his religion. And she knew how much he loved her. So Sa'ad, he refused. And she tried standing in the hot heat in Mecca, not eating or drinking. She was trying to make him feel ashamed that he'll be the one that the Quraysh will say. He killed his mother. He refused to save his mother. They will shame him with this. But Sa'ad was firm. And he said to her, Ya Ummah, O my mother, if you had 1,000 souls, وتخرج الواحدة بعد الأخرى, and one comes out one after the other, لما تركت ديني, I would never left my religion. ولما رأت صرامته أكل وشربت واستبطت. When she saw how serious he was and how firm he was, she ate and she drank and she saw shade. These were the Sahaba, the Mawaqif. So Mus'ab radiallahu anhu, the messenger sent him to Al-Madinah as an ambassador to call the people of Medina to Al-Islam. He was there. And with him was a man, a Sahabi. His name was As'ad ibn Zurar. This man was helping him. So, in Al-Madinah, the situation was that Aws and Khazraj, these two tribes, they had fought and they had a civil war. And because they were constantly fighting, this time all the elders were wiped away. There was no more old men. So Al-Madinah was filled with young men. This was an opportunity. Whilst Mus'ab radiallahu anhu was calling the people to Islam, some of the leaders of the Ansar, the people of Medina, the two different tribes, Aws and Khazraj, they heard about this. Some of them wanted to stop him, and some of them were intrigued. From amongst these leaders was a good Sahabi, at the time was not Muslim. His name was Sa'ad ibn Mu'adh radiallahu anhu. He's from the leaders of the Aws. He sent a man called Usayd to go find out about the da'wah of Mus'ab. What is he doing? So he saw As'ad ibn Zurar, who was his relative, with Mus'ab. So he asked him, I want to know about what he's doing. And he had with him a spear. And he was sent to stop his da'wah. But he went and he listened to Mus'ab. So Mus'ab radiallahu anhu started talking to him about Islam. He spoke to him about Islam and then he recited him verses from the Quran. And Mus'ab radiallahu anhu, he says, when I saw his face, without him having to say anything, I could tell that this face is a face that's going to accept Islam. After Mus'ab finished reciting the Quran, Usayd said, Ma ajmala. What is more beautiful than his speech? And he said, if one wanted to join this religion, what does he have to do? So they told him, go purify yourself and come back and utter the testimony of faith. And then he prayed even to rak'ahs. After that he said, I know a man. If this man accepts this religion, all of his people will accept his faith. I'll bring him to you. And this man was Sa'ad ibn Mu'adh radiallahu anhu wa Allah. So Sa'ad comes with Sayyid ثم مصعب، المصعب موسى الإسلام. ثم سعد رضي الله عنه في accepts Islam. And after he accepts Islam, he hastens, he rushes to his people. And he says to them, he calls them all. He's their leader. He said, if I commanded you to do anything, would you ever refuse my command? They said, no. If I told you anything, would you believe me? They said, we'll believe you. He said, I have accepted this faith and Islam. And I command you all, and I call you all to accept it. And after they heard his call, every single person amongst his people accepted Islam. SubhanAllah. He just accepted Islam and now he got all his people to accept Islam. Allahu Akbar. He's 30 years of age, Sa'd ibn Mu'adh. This man, he is the man that the Messenger alayhi salatu wasalam said, اهتز عرش الرحمن لموت سعد بن معاذ. The throne of Allah Azza wa Jal, it shook due to the death of Sa'd ibn Mu'adh radiallahu anhu. What did he do to deserve this? He had many mawaqif, incidents in his life which showed what he did to deserve this. Radiallahu anhu Allah. When the battle of Badr came, the Messenger alayhi salatu wasalam, he had a pledge with the Ansar of Medina that they would protect Medina from any enemies as long as it's within the boundaries of Medina. This is the pledge that they agreed upon. So the battle of Badr was not planned. Rather, the Messenger alayhi salatu wasalam, he even made the option to go out with him. He told the Sahaba, we are going to seize the caravan of Abu Sufyan that came from Sham. And this had the wealth of the Muslimin that was stolen by Quraysh. So we're going to seize it. So only 300 men went out with the Messenger alayhi salatu wasalam. Not many horses or camels. So they went out and the caravan escaped. And news got to Quraysh and the Messenger of Allah tried to seize their caravan. So Abu Jahl and the men of Quraysh, the leaders of Quraysh, they prepared an army of 1,000 heading out towards Medina. And once they headed out, halfway, when they stopped one of the nights and they were slaughtered 100 camels every day to eat. Imagine! News came to them that the caravan had escaped and it was safe and nothing was taken from it. So some of the leaders of Quraysh, like Atba, said, let's go back, there's no need for us to fight now. But people like Abu Jahl said, no, we're not cowards. This is our opportunity to destroy them. So, the majority chose the opinion of Abu Jahl. And they decided, let's go out. And the Messenger of Allah, he had no choice but to fight. He's given no other choice. And Allah Azza wa Jal had already promised him, one or the other, the caravan, or that he would win the battle. So he knows, alayhi salatu wasalam, that he'd be victorious. But look at the hikmah and the wisdom he had, alayhi salatu wasalam. He consulted the Sahaba. He said, shall we go out? He said, ashiru alayya ayyuhal nas. Ashiru alayya ayyuhal nas. So Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu spoke. And he said, ya Rasulullah, we are with you, we'll stand with you, we'll fight with you. And then Umar spoke, and he said the same. And then Al-Baghdad spoke, and he said the same. And all of these men are from Al-Muhajireen. those who migrated from Mecca. So the Messenger of Allah kept repeating, Ajiru alayya ayyuhal nas. Ajiru alayya ayyuhal nas. Give me your opinions, I want to hear what you think. And Sa'ad ibn Mu'adh radiallahu anhu, he understood that the Messenger of Allah, he intended them, the Ansar. He said, كَأَنَّكَ تُرِيدُونَ يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ. It is as if you are intending us, O Messenger of Allah. And then he said, لَقَدْ آمَنَّا بِكَ وَصَدَّقْنَاكَ وَعَطَيْنَاكَ وَحُوتُنَا وَمُوَافِيقُنَا عَلَى السَّمْعِ وَالطَّاعَةِ. فَمُنِّي يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ بِمَا مَرَدْتَ فوالذي بعثك بالحق إن استعرضت بنا هذا البحر فخذته لخذناه معك ولم يتخلف منا رجل واحد. He said, O Messenger of Allah, we have believed in you and we have given you pledge of allegiance to hear and obey. And wallahi, if you told us to cross the sea, you took us to sea and told us to cross it with you, we would cross it with you without any hesitation. And not a single man amongst us will stay behind. So he said, Ya Rasulullah, do as you wish. We are with you. And you will see from us what will make you happy. And the Messenger عليه الصلاة والسلام was delighted to hear this. And the Ansar were on board because they didn't have to. This is one of the incidents that Sa'd ibn Mu'an, he showed his love for the Messenger and the Deen of Allah Azza wa Jalla. Also, in another mawqif, another incident, that Sa'd radiallahu anhu wa Allah, he participated in the battle of Al-Khandaq, the trench. And in this battle, he had been wounded. So Sa'd radiallahu anhu, he had made a dua. He said, Ya Allah, if there is any battle left between the Messenger alayhi salatu wasalam and Quraysh, then let me stay alive to witness them, to fight alongside the Messenger alayhi salatu wasalam. And if there are none left, then take my soul to you, Ya Allah. Like he was badly wounded. And after he made his dua, there was no battles left. And he had died due to this wound. And the Messenger alayhi salatu wasalam was saddened by this severely. And he said that Sa'd ibn Mu'adh is from those who are of the people of Jannah. And he said, alayhi salatu wasalam, that the throne of Allah Azza wa Jal had shook due to the death of Sa'd ibn Mu'adh. He accepted Islam at the age of 30. And he died at the age of 36 or 37. 7-6 years he managed to accomplish all of this. Now we need to ask ourselves, we probably have been Muslim for many years, born Muslim, what have we done for our religion? What have we accomplished for our religion? And that starts from yourself. What have you accomplished for yourself? For verily Allah Azza wa Jal, He doesn't change the affairs of a people except that they change what's within them. إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُغَيِّرُ مَا بِقَوْمٍ حَتَّى يُغَيِّرُ مَا بِأَنفُسِهِمْ. You start with yourself. You rectify yourself. And that's exactly what Sa'd ibn Mu'adh radiallahu anhu did. That's exactly what he did. He started with himself. And then he started with others. What have you accomplished for this vision? These people, these Sahaba, they are our Qudwa, our Romans. And the Messenger of Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he told us to follow. We ask Allah Azza wa Jalla to make us from those who rectify their affairs. We ask Allah Azza wa Jalla to make us from those who take the Messenger and Sahaba as role models. إِنَّهُ وَلِي ذَلِكُ الْقَاتِرُ عَلِي أَقُولُ قَوْلِ هَذَا وَاسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهَ لِي وَلَكُمْ فَاسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهَ. الحمد لله على إحسانه والشكر له على توفيقه وامتنانه وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له تعظيما لشانه وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله الداعي إلى رضوانه صلى الله وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وخلانه ومن سار على نهجه واختفى أثره إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد، عباد الله، Allah Jalla wa Ala, he says in the Quran, وَالَّذِينَ جَاءُوا مِنْ بَعْدِهِمْ يَقُولُونَ رَبَّنَا اغْفِرْ لَنَا وَلِإِخْوَانِنَا الَّذِينَ سَبَقُونَا بِالْإِيمَانِ وَلَا تَجْعَلْ فِي قُلُوبِنَا غِلًّا لِلَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. And those who came after them, they say, our Lord, forgive those who preceded us in faith. Forgive us and those who and our brothers who preceded us in faith. And don't put in our heart, don't place in our hearts hatred towards those who believe. And mu'min, the believer, he must be a person who has salamatul sadr, a sound heart towards the believers.
Allah.
This is what this ayah, it tells us that we need to ask Allah and that we need to be. And the Sahaba radhiyallahu anhum, this is how they worked with each other. There were people who had salamatul sadr. They had no enmity, hatred towards each other and believers in their hearts. Rather, they had love towards each other. And rahmah, mercy, and rafah. This is how they were. This is what they learned from the Messenger alayhi salatu wasalam. And this is the example that he set for them. فَبَيْنِ لَغَدْ كَانَ لَكُمْ فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ أُسْوَةٌ حَسَنَةٌ لِمَنْ كَانَ يَرْجُو اللَّهَ وَالْيَوْمَ الْآخِرَ وَذَكَرَ اللَّهَ كَثِيرًا. And these people, due to their hearts, because they rectified their hearts, and they rectified the state of their hearts, Allah Jalla wa Ala, He rectified their apparent state. And because Allah Azza wa Jalla rectified their apparent state, their mujtama, the society, was rectified. And that's what we have in the hadith of the Messenger alayhi salatu wasalam.
Allah.
That he said alayhi salatu wasalam, بَدَى الْإِسْلَامُ غريبا وسيعود غريبا ف فطوبى للغرباء. Islam started strange, and it will return strange. So glad tidings to the strange ones. Who are they? He defined them, alayhi salatu wasalam. He said, الَّذِينَ يُصْلِحُونَ مَا أَفْسَدَ النَّاسِ. Those who rectify what the people corrupt. Or in another riwayah, الَّذِينَ those who rectify themselves when the people are corrupted. This is the definition that the Messenger alayhi salatu wasalam gave to those who are ghuraba, for the glad tidings have been given to. So rectification is where emphasis is placed. That you rectify your state, and then you rectify the state of others. النفع لابد أن يتعدى إلى الغير. The benefit, it must reach others. Once it reaches you, it must reach others too. And this is what Islam is about. Allah Jalla wa'ala, the marahil, the Quran was revealed in, the first verse was revealed to the Messenger alayhi salatu wasalam was Iqra. Read. You seek the benefit. The second verses that are revealed to the Messenger عليه الصلاة والسلام is Surah Muddathir. يَا أَيُّهَا الْمُدَّثِرْ قُمْ فَأَنذِرْ. O you who is covered up, stand and warn. لَبُدَّ يَتْعَدَّ النَّفْعُ لِلْغَيْرِ. The benefit, it must reach others. And still, the next verses that came after, يَا أَيُّهَا الْمُزَّمِّلْ قُمِ اللَّيْلَ إِلَّا قَلِيلًا. You still work on rectifying yourself. عِبَادَةً نُون وَالْقَلِمِ مَا يَسْطُرُونَ. In this surah, إِنَّكَ لَعَلَى خُلُقٍ عَظِيمٍ. You are upon great manners. These are the first four verses. As Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu, he states that were revealed from the Qur'an in that order. Rectification. From gaining the benefit to calling others to it. Working and still rectifying yourself through your ibadah and your character. كَانَ خُلُقُهُ الْقُرْآنِ. She said, radiallahu anha. Aisha radiallahu anha, when she was asked about the Messenger alayhi salatu wasalam, his etiquette was the Qur'an. We ask Allah Azza wa Jalla to make us from those who imitate the Messenger alayhi salatu wasalam. We ask Allah Azza wa Jalla to make us from those who rectify their affairs. We ask Allah Azza wa Jalla to make us from ibadihi salihin. We ask Allah Azza wa Jalla to make us from those who have taqwa. Allahumma inna nas'aluka al-huda wal-tuqa wal-afafa wal-ghina. Allahumma ati nufusana taqwaha wa zakkiha anta khayru min zakkaha anta waliyuha wa mawlaha. اللهم إنا نعوذ بك من زوال نعمتك وفجاءة نقمتك وتحول عافيتك وجميع سخطك. اللهم إنا نسألك عيش السعداء ونزل الشهداء والحشر مع الأتقياء ومرافقة الأنبياء. ونعوذ بك ربنا من جهد البلاء ودرك الشقاء وسوء القضاء وشماتة الأعداء. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين وأذل الشرك والمشركين ودمر أعداءك أعداء الدين واحمي حوزة الإسلام واجمع كلمته هم على الحق يا رب العالمين. اللهم انصر من نصر الدين واخذل من خذل الدين يا رب العالمين. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. عباد الله, إن الله أمركم بأمر. الله عز وجل has commanded you with a fair that he started himself, and then the angels, and then you, O believers. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. بلغ العلا بكماله كشف الدجى بجماله حسنت جميع خصاله صلوا عليه وآله. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وقوموا إلى